This building right here, specifically the second floor, is a place I've featured on my channel a few times in the past. But it's been a few years since I've been here.
That's known as the Hudson Model Railroad Club. I'm here today because today is Conrail Day. They advertise the all the locomotive power for today is Conrail Power, which happens to be the same company that started my interest in trains. They also advertised to make some changes to their impressive layout. So you're invited to come along with me as we check out some Conrail action here at the Hudson Model Railroad Club.
All right, so we're back inside here. We're gonna take a walk around, check out the layout, see if we could spot the changes, and keep your eye out for the blue locomotives, the Conrails. So I was talking with one of the members here, and they did state there's actually numerous projects that are taking place. We're gonna see them as we make our way around. Some are in various stages of completion, but they do have plans to definitely alter what we've seen in the past, but still a lot of the same from what we remember as well. So as we make our way around, if you haven't seen my previous videos, you can check the playlist links down below. Otherwise, just keep your eyes peeled, see what you notice, and I'll share what I can. It did state too, hopefully we should be able to get some on-rail action. So the camera I'm filming with right now, we should be able to run on the rails and get a cab view around the impressive layout here. That right there is a thing of beauty, Conrail steam locomotive. There's Mr. Scarecrow, and the one thing I love is that the locomotives are weathered, so they look super realistic. Up here at the Iron Hill Rock Quarry. Got a loaded train ready to depart. Conrail switcher sitting here idling, number 8905. Not weathered, but still a really sharp looking locomotive. It's like a SW7. And if you've noticed or not, this is actually a Conrail unit as well. Not all of them were blue, at least not initially. Looks more like DL colors. It's all Conrail equipment, including the caboose. So coming around over here is where we're going to notice some of the work that's currently being done to the layout. Not completed, obviously. That means we'll have to return back in the future to see the finished product. But there was, I remember, a big factory up there, and they're going with something completely different. Sketchy Train Bridge 3.0, third time's a charm, not sketchy enough. And as this one passes by, there is some more idling equipment here, including the former Penn Central. You actually see the old logo on it with the CR stamped over it. Another of my favorite scenes here too, the little shack area with the basically a scrapyard. Everything from busted up cars to tires, pallets. Really a lot of detail. The home for sale, I guess they haven't sold it yet. Tough market right now. Planters Peanuts.
Thank you. probably has some filling. One of those loosens the other one's in the other way, because the third one is fine. The third one's max. When they sound better at the 25, 50, I think the motors, one of them, the motors is not as good.
Thank you.
Conrail Day at the Hudson Model Railroad Club did not disappoint. There was more than enough Conrail action, and the members were gracious enough to once again let us run the action camera around the layout a few different times. Had to do it in portrait mode because the camera is too wide. It would have hit some of the scenery, buildings, and oncoming trains. And as you saw, even standing it up, there was some close calls and some clearance issues where the camera got toppled over, but it makes for some good footage. Hope you guys enjoyed the photo montage as well. I was using my new camera to get some really detailed shots. And they said that the projects, most of them, like the sawmill, the towns, and stuff like that, are supposed to be completed by the next open house coming up this summer. So make sure to check out their Facebook page, linked down below, and the playlist for model train layouts, which you can find down below as well as see their previous layout from past years. But I will be back again in the near future to share it with you guys. If you're in the area yourself, come here and check it out. It's free. They do accept donations, and they do a great job. Members are really friendly, and they're accommodating, and they enjoy the publicity. So it's a win-win for you guys and for them. And I wanted to mention, too, that the weathering that they do is primarily all done by the members. So obviously, it's trial and error. Practice does kind of make perfect, but the equipment, especially like the mixed freight, the box cars and stuff like that with the graffiti and stuff like that, looks phenomenal, really realistic and detailed. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you had an enjoyable time checking out Conrail Day here at the Hudson Model Railroad Club. Until next time, everyone, I'll see you in the next video.
Yeah. Oh. I'm going to do the work.